we believe that the population of the world is going to grow and grow, so the cities are going to get larger and larger. And normally we used to enlarge our cities using steel and concrete, but these two materials are highly pollutant. So the way to go is timber structures, and actually there are already plans for high-rise timber structures up to 30 stories. But the major challenge with timber is that it burns, and this is where my research comes to play. I'm trying to make high-rise timber structures safe for fire. Being nominated to represent women in STEM has actually two meanings for me. On one hand side, I'm always looking towards change in this field because this is affecting me in a daily basis. On the other hand, I have to admit that this has been like a personal achievement, so I'm really happy that I was the person nominated, and it always feels really good to achieve something. I would like to motivate other young women to pursue STEM careers actually by becoming a mentor. Now, when I'm tutoring at UQ, I can see that in difficult subjects, when students stop following the lessons, they close themselves. And especially girls, I can see that they are more shy, so they are shy to ask for help and to look into other resources. They just don't believe that they can understand. I think we've been dragging gender imbalance for centuries, and now gender imbalance is so deeply in our culture that many times we are not even able to see it. And I think the whole society has to change from the bottom right to the top,